गुड मॉर्निंग शैम स्टार्स, वेलकम टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास. टुडे वी विल डू डिवाइडिंग बाय 10. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद डिवाइडिंग बाय 10. फर्स्ट एग्जांपल इज डिवाइड 41 बाय 10. राइट डिविडेंड इनसाइड द ब्रैकेट, डिवाइजर आउटसाइड द ब्रैकेट. 10 फोर ज़ा 40. 41 माइनस 40 विल बी इक्वल टू 1. And here it means quotient is 4 and remainder is 1. So we write quotient 4, remainder 1. Second question is we are having divide 143 by 10. Means when we divide 143 by 10, then 10 ones are 10. 4 minus 0, 4 and bring 3 downs, 10 fours are 40. 43 minus 40 will be equal to 3. That means quotient is 14. And remainder is 3. Now, did you observe any pattern? Yes, of course. The pattern is that if we divide a number by 10, then the digit in the ones place is the remainder, while the remaining digits form the quotient. Ones place digit will be the remainder, whereas the other remaining numbers, whether there are two numbers, three numbers or one number, that is the quotient of the question. Like here in activity 10, we are having question number 1, 64 divided by 10. When we divide the 64 by 10, then what is the remainder? The numbers in the ones place. In ones place, we are having 4. That means 4 is the remainder and 6 is the quotient. Second question is 930 divided by 10. That means what is the quotient? Number on ones place. Ones place means 0. So remainder is 0 and quotient is 93. So third question is 4320 divided by 10. So when we divide it by 10, the number on ones place is the remainder. That is 0 is the remainder and 432 is quotient. The three numbers that are left over is the quotient. Then if we divide 463 by 10, then what is the remainder? 3, because 3 is on the ones place and 46 is the quotient. When we divide 1209 by 10, then 9 is the remainder and 120 is the quotient, the remaining numbers. Here in 89 divided by 10, 9 is the remainder and 8 is the quotient. So you have to do activity 10 in book only, and we will start with the activity 11, that is word problem. And in the word problem, we are having first question: a shopkeeper sells 72 shirts in a day. How many shirts does he sell in 24 days? Means in one day he sells 72 shirts, then in 24 days how many shirts will he sell in 24 days? So that means how we will write? Number of shirts sold in one day is equal to 72. Number of shirts sold in 24 days will be equal to 72 multiply by 24. Then we will write the multiplicand and multiplier on the places. Then we will start the multiplication. 4 2 is 8. Then 4 7 is 28. Then 0 on ones place below 8, 2 2s are 4, 2 7s are 14. Then we add these two numbers, 8 plus 0, 8, 8 plus 4, 12, 2, 1 carry, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 4, 7 and 1. So 1728 shirts sold in 24 days, means the shopkeeper sold 1728 shirts in 24 days. Second question is, Anusha went to the market with rupees 3250. She spent rupees 2738. How much money is left with her? How we will write? Money with Anusha is equal to rupees 3250. And then money spent by Anusha is equals to rupees 2738. Then money left with Anusha is equals to rupees 3250 minus 2738. When we subtract these two numbers, write the subtrahend and minuend. Then 0 minus 8 is not possible, so it will become 10. 10 minus 8 will be 2. here in place of 5 it will become 4. 4 minus 3 equal to 1. Then 2 minus 7 is not possible, so it will become 12, and on place of 3 it will become 2. That is 12 minus 7 will be 5, and 2 minus 2 will be equal to 0. Thus Anusha left with rupees 512. Third question is, Jayanti sticks 6 pictures on a page. How many pages does she need to stick 672 pictures? Means number of pictures on page is equal to 6. Number of pictures is equals to 672. Number of pages required is equal to 672 divided by 6. When we divide 672 by 6, what do we get? 6 ones are 6. 6 minus 6 will be equal to 0. Then we bring 7 down. 6 ones are 6. 7 minus 6 is 1. Then we bring 2 down. 6 twos are 12. 12 minus 12 will be equal to 0. Thus Jayanti needs 112 pages. Means the number of pages required is 112. Next is fourth question. There are 1256 girls and 1838 boys in a school. What is the total number of students in the school? So we have to write number of girls is equals to 1256. Number of boys is equals to 1838. Then total number of students will be equal to 1256 plus 1838. When we add these two numbers, 6 plus 8, 14, 4, 1 carry. 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 3, 9. 2 plus 8, 10, 0, 1 carry. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3, 0, 9, 4. Thus, there are 3, 0, 9, 4 students in school. The remaining question is your homework. You have to complete activity 10 in book only and activity 11 in notebook. Tomorrow we will do review exercise. Thank you, Shamstars. That's all for today. You can drop your queries on Google Classroom. Thank you and have a nice day.